I really love you, and I mean you. The star above you, crystal blue. But oh, baby, my hair's all and about you. Floating, bumping noses, dodger tooth, their fins are luminous. Fangs all round, the clown is dark below, the boulders hiding all the sunlight's good for us. The fishes and all we do, the move about is all we do. 'Cause oh baby, my head's on end about you.
All right. Hello there, thrill seekers. And in case you ever wonder what your donations might be put to use for, here's an example. I need to get a mic stand because, it's raining outside today, so I had to move everything indoors in order to make today's video. And in order to get this mic close enough to my mouth, normally I have it on a picnic table, you know, and it's sitting kind of close to me. But I don't have anything inside that's as high as a picnic table. So I had to put the mic on. I have it awkwardly propped on top of a guitar stand that's sitting on top of an amplifier to make the guitar stand high enough to reach up towards my mouth. Yeah, I really need a mic stand. So that would be one thing that I would use your donation money for. So anyway, the music you heard at the beginning of today's video was the song Terrapin by Syd Barrett. And that was all me. Sometimes when I make these videos, or pretty often when I make these videos, I have pre-recorded parts so that it all sounds better. Mostly when you hear a song by me at the beginning of these videos, at least one part you're hearing is being done live by me on the video. Like yesterday, the lead guitar part and one of the vocals was live onto the video, but the rest of it was pre-recorded. Well, today everything was live onto the video, so that was me raw and alive. And in case you're wondering why the background is what it is today, of course it's a green screen, but it has to do with the theme of today's video, which I kind of decided on spontaneously. I had a different idea for today's video, but this morning when I was kind of getting ready to do the video and kind of procrastinating as I often do, I started looking at videos of the Kiss Cruise. Okay, so some of you probably already know this if you've read my books. I'm a big fan of the band Kiss, and I wrote in Hardcore Zen about my meetings with Gene Simmons from Kiss, and that was a big thrill of my life when I got to meet him in the context of working for Tsuburaya Productions. In case you haven't read the book, I was working for Tsuburaya Productions, the people who make Ultraman in Japan, big superhero show, and Kiss was coming to Japan, and I knew that Gene Simmons was a big fan of Godzilla, and Tsuburaya Productions was founded by the creator of Godzilla, so I invited him to come to the company. Maybe I thought we'd get a little publicity out of it, and he might get interested in seeing some of the monster costumes and stuff. And he wanted to talk to us about making a Kiss animated series, and we had two meetings with Gene Simmons, and nothing came of it, but it was fun meeting him, and I got to talk to him, and I wrote about it in the book. Okay. So that was a big thrill. and I'm a big Kiss fan. So right now, even as I am making this video, the very last Kiss cruise, apparently, Kiss is always announcing the very last this or that. That particular tour that I went and saw him on and that I invited him to go to Tsuburaya Productions, that was done in, I think, the year 2000. And that was announced as the last Kiss tour. And of course, they're still on tour. So that was, but it was the last tour with the original lineup. So, you know, so that was true. Anyhow, so this is supposedly the last Kiss cruise, and a Kiss cruise is where the band Kiss gets on a boat with a bunch of other bands, and they do all these Kiss theme things, and they take you, I think this time they're leaving from, or they left, because they're already on, from Los Angeles, and they sail down to Ensenada, Mexico, and then back, and all these Kiss fans are there hooping it up and watching Kiss perform several shows a day, and it's really even more thrilling because one of the other bands on the tour is Warrant. And Warrant, the drummer for Warrant is he's called Steven Sweet is his stage name, but his real name is Steve Chamberlain. And Steve Chamberlain, when he was Steve Chamberlain, was a friend of mine. Not just like somebody I knew and saw occasionally. We were friends back in high school. We went to the same high school together and we ate lunch together and I hung out with his band and I used to carry their amps and stuff and we knew each other back in high school, and I've seen him a handful of times since, so it would have been a great thrill. I really, really, really wanted to go on the Kiss cruise and see them, especially because my connection with Steve, I might have been able to, you know, use that connection to buddy up with the Kiss people. But I couldn't find anybody. My wife didn't want to go on the Kiss cruise. Nobody I knew wanted to go on the Kiss cruise, and I just thought, you know, going on the Kiss cruise just by myself. I'm kind of a shy person. I don't make friends easily. And just the idea of going on the Kiss cruise alone just seemed like just too depressing. So I didn't sign up for going on the Kiss cruise alone. Maybe I should have. Maybe I should have just, you know, had some stones and gone on the Kiss cruise by myself. But I just didn't see that as a viable option because, you know, anyway. So I didn't go on the Kiss cruise. And this morning I was watching some videos of made by people who are on the Kiss cruise right now and going, oh my God, that looks like so much fun. And that looks like a great thing. And it got me thinking about something that happened, a little incident which you folks on this video, who watch this video channel, might be interested in. And my memory's a bit vague on this whole thing, but the incident happened around, I think, 2005. Because I remember I had just returned to the United States, and I hadn't been here very long. I'd been in Japan a long time. So I returned back to the United States from Japan at the end of 2004. So this would have been, I guess, early 2005. And I got contacted by email by somebody who wanted me to be part of a spiritual cruise. So they told me all this stuff. This person told me all this stuff about how So it was going to be a cruise. I forget where the cruise was going to take place. Probably more or less the same route as the Kiss cruise is taking, from probably Los Angeles to Ensenada, Mexico, I'm guessing. Somewhere like that. Or maybe it was South America. Maybe it was, yeah, I don't remember. Anyway, and I'm going, okay, well, what's the deal with this? And they were like, well, you'll get to share your teachings on this cruise, and there'll be all these people who want to go learn spirituality from you. And I'm going, okay, well, that's a little weird. I don't know, a cruise ship with meditation? And they're going, well, we would have some meditation sessions. I'm going, well, how many meditation sessions are there going to be? What's exactly going to go on this cruise? And they told me what was going to go on the cruise. And to me, when they started talking about the events that were going to go on the cruise, it sounded like your standard cruise ship stuff, like a lot of eating, a lot of getting off the boat and doing touristy stuff, a lot of coming back, a lot of eating, a lot of partying, a lot more eating, you know, a couple of little seminars of spirituality I'd be able to lead I don't know, a couple of 1 hour seminars here and there and talk about my spiritual stuff. You know, I think maybe once a day I would have an hour to sit and talk with people about my spiritual stuff. And then the rest of the time we'd be cruising and eating and chowing down and drinking and partying and going out and seeing ruins and coming back and partying and and just cruise ship stuff. And after hearing their description, I was more of a hothead in 2005. It doesn't seem like that, you know. When I say 2005, it doesn't seem that long ago, but 2005 is 50, what, 17, 18 years ago? I don't know. It was a long time ago now that when you add up the years, but anyway. I was more inclined to get angrier at at that time. And I remember getting a little bit kind of going, "What the hell are you talking about?" and sending them after several email exchanges, sending them a rather, not exactly angry, but a rather tersely worded refusal, saying basically, I felt like, oh, you're just basically using me as kind of bait to get a bunch of, rich people to go on a cruise. You know, this isn't, there's nothing here in this description you've sent me that has anything to do with what I teach. You know, I teach silent seated meditation, and the standard form of what I do is these retreats where we spend 4 to 6 hours a day meditating, you know, in silence, in usually a temple setting, in a quiet rural setting. And this is nothing like that. This is just a bunch of people partying down on a cruise ship, you know, with me as the bait to get them to go on the cruise ship. And no, I don't want to do this. Thank you. Goodbye. You know, see you later. And after I sent them that message, I never heard back from them again. They didn't even send me like an acknowledgement that they'd received that mail. I must have made my point a bit too strongly. And so, I don't know, a few months later, or I don't know how much longer later, I happened to be talking to a guy who sort of, there is this, I wasn't even aware of this. There's a sort of marketplace of people like that who used to kind of, flit around me in those days because they saw me as maybe part of something they could exploit back then. And interestingly enough, I never hear from people like this anymore. But around 2005 to maybe circa 2005 to 2010, I would occasionally, these people would come around who were people who were looking to exploit, a popular spiritual teacher for things like this. And there was one of these guys, and I started talking to him, and he was trying to hype me up on some other similar thing that I also was not very interested in. And he started talking to me, and I told him about this spiritual cruise. I said, "Yeah, I got something similar like that a few years ago, a few months ago, whatever it was, spiritual cruise," and told him about it and how I wasn't interested in it, and how I, told him to go, go away. And he said, "Well, how much were they offering you as your fee to do this thing?" And I said, "Well, I never got to that part because by the, before we ever got to discussing my fee about it, I just basically told him to go away." And he said, "No, that's interesting. They were probably going to offer you about $10,000." And I went, jaw dropped to the floor. Because at that point, I wasn't making much money. I was actually financially in bad shape. Like I was really struggling to try to, just pay the rent at that point. And I was going, $10,000, my God. It never even, the whole time I'd been negotiating, if you can call it that, with these cruise people, it never even occurred to me. I don't know if I even thought about what they would pay me, how much they would pay me, or anything like that. I guess I guess if you'd asked me at the time, I would have assumed I would get paid something. But it wouldn't have occurred to me I would get paid a lot. I don't know, maybe they'd comp my cruise or they'd give me $1,000 or something like that. It never would have occurred to me that I'd make a lot of money at it. Never would have even entered my mind that I would have gotten $10,000 for hanging out on a cruise ship for 3 days with some rich people. You know, and I thought about it at the time, and I thought, would I have done it if I'd known it was $10,000? And I thought, yeah, probably not. I probably still would. It would have swayed my decision, you know, knowing how dirt poor I was at the time. I might have given it a little more thought if I'd known there was $10,000. I might have thought, well, I don't know, maybe for $10,000 I could just sit in a room with some rich people and talk to them about Zen for a while. And, you know, I don't know if I would have gone for it at $10,000. Honestly, just between you and me and the wall behind me, well, the cruise ship, fake cruise ship behind me, I don't know, maybe I would have done it. Given how little I was making at the time, I might have sold out, you know, because I don't know how bad it would have been. But still, the fact that these things exist, you know, I didn't know this kind of stuff existed. And it does exist. And I hear about it every once in a while. I hear about these spiritual cruises and things that go on. And there's this whole, you know, the San Francisco Zen Center and a lot of the big Zen centers in America are supported by this kind of, you know, people like Ken Wilber and people like that. They're supported by this cadre of sort of wealthy people, retired, sort of, you know, usually politically left-leaning people who are into causes and stuff. I hate to say they're left-leaning, but, you know, there's this type of person. They listen to way too much NPR and stuff, and they support all this stuff, and they want to throw their money at causes they think that are good, that they, I guess, assuages their guilt over having too much money or something. And you know, there's this whole... A lot of the spiritual type people who are in the business that I am in get their money from folks like this, from the kind of people who go on spiritual cruises, who want to throw money at people because they think they're good. And, you know, I was and I am aware of that source of money that one can get doing this, but it feels dirty to me, and I don't want to do it. You know, I just don't want to do it because there is a way to tap into those folks, you know, and I've seen it being done. When I've hung around Tassajara, the San Francisco Zen Center's meditation retreat center that up there in the Carmel Valley, I've watched it. I've actually watched it in action. I've watched the people from the San Francisco Zen Center tapping, you know, those people, like putting the tap in there and getting the sap out of those rich folks and saying, you know, doing the things and saying the things that they want to hear and doing the things that they want to do. And, you know, it really compromises what they do. And I've watched those places just get deeply, deeply compromised. And most of the big Zen centers in America, I would say, are deeply, deeply compromised these days from how much they are beholden to rich donors. And it really explains a lot of the things that go on in those centers, particularly recently particularly in the last 2 years, some of the decisions these big Zen centers have made and some of the restrictions and things they've made and who they let in and who they won't let in, a lot of it has to do with how beholden they are to the rich donors that they are kind of in the thrall of. So... yeah, that's a thing that goes on, and it's really kind of disgusting, if you want to know my personal opinion about it. And yeah, that's about spiritual cruises. That's how you do it. That's how this business works. You know, that would be a good book for me to write, kind of an expose of the spiritual business. Of course, I'm not tied into it probably enough to really write the expose, but if any of you are tied into it enough and want to give me insider information, so and want to help me write a book that exposes the whole corruption and things that goes on in the spiritual business, I would love to write that book. But anyway, if you want to donate to me not going on spiritual cruises, you can go to the URL that you're seeing on the screen below, which is Hardcore Zen. .info/donate. That is hardcorezen.info/donate. As I've spent the last 18 minutes telling you, I do not get my money from going on spiritual cruises or tapping into rich donors in the Bay Area. I get it mostly from $5 and $1 donations from you guys, and I really appreciate your support. But as always, you don't got to support me if you don't want to support me, because I offer this for free. So we will see you next time. Have a good time all the time. I wish I was on the Kiss Cruise, but instead I'm talking to you folks, and I enjoy that too. And maybe we'll talk about desire next time, because I got a real strong desire to be on the Kiss Cruise. We'll see you again. Have a good time all the time. Bye. Hey, Ziggy, how you doing? We got to stay inside because it's raining out there. How you feeling? We'll go out and take a walk later when the rain stops, okay? All right, buddy. How you doing there? All right, I'm gonna go edit the video. We'll talk to you later. Bye.